Welcome to the second video in the Project Fundamentals series. In this video, we're building on the scenario we introduced in Part 1, managing marketing requests for a product launch. This time, we'll take the data from an approved project in our intake sheet, use it to create a detailed project plan, and explore key project tracking features like setting baselines, tracking the critical path, creating workback schedules, and managing resources effectively. Let's dive in. We're starting with our intake sheet, where requests have been submitted and reviewed. First, locate an approved request. Identify the key details, then use this information to create a project plan. In the project sheet, input the request details into appropriate rows, adding additional rows for subtasks as needed. Use the hierarchy feature to organize your plan into collapsible phases by indenting subtasks under their parent tasks. For clarity, designate the top-level row as the project name or summary so that it represents the entire project at a glance. Using hierarchy in your project plan offers clear organization by distinguishing high-level parent tasks from detailed subtasks. Ensure each task has a start and end date, and assign owners to tasks using the Assign To column. With the plan now complete, we can take advantage of Smartsheet's project settings to unlock powerful tools for visualizing and managing our project more effectively. To begin, switch to Gantt view by selecting it from the View dropdown. Doing so transforms your project into a visual timeline, making planning and managing tasks easier. Additionally, it is the view that best integrates with project settings, providing the features needed to optimize your project timeline. Project settings can be accessed by selecting the gear icon underneath the Share button. It is here that we find the option to enable dependencies, which define the relationships between tasks, ensuring that work flows in the correct order and your schedule adjusts automatically when changes occur. Notice, after turning on dependencies, duration and predecessor columns will be added to your sheet. Predecessors allow you to define relationships between tasks. Each predecessor represents the row number of the task it depends on. For example, if the task in row 4 depends on the task in row 3, you would enter 3 in the predecessors column for row 4. After pressing Enter, notice that an arrow appears in the Gantt chart, connecting the task in row 3 to the task in row 4. This visual indicator highlights the dependent relationship between the two tasks, showing that row 4's task cannot start until row 3's task is completed. Alternatively, you can create a relationship directly in the Gantt chart by clicking and holding on one taskbar, then dragging your cursor to another taskbar to draw the connection. By default, these relationships are finished to start and are critical when setting up timelines, especially for workback schedules, which will be discussed later. The duration column determines how long a task will take to complete and directly impacts dependent tasks. For example, if the duration of the task in row 3 increases from 4 days to 5 days, the start date of the dependent task in row 4 will automatically adjust, pushing it back by 1 day. To set a baseline to track your project's progress against the original plan, select the Baseline tab. Show Baseline in Gantt. Then, OK to capture the current state of your project timeline. As tasks progress, compare the baseline with the actual timeline to identify delays, changes, or areas that need attention. The critical path highlights the tasks that directly affect your project's completion date. Select Show Critical Path from the toolbar while in Gantt view to identify these tasks. The tasks that must be completed on time to prevent delays in the overall schedule will then be highlighted in red. Regularly monitor these tasks to ensure your project remains on track, focusing your efforts where they matter most. A workback schedule is a great approach for projects with fixed deadlines. Instead of building the timeline forward, start with the final task and work backward. Set the end date for the last task to establish your project's endpoint. Assign durations to tasks that need to be completed before the final deliverable. Define start-to-finish relationships between tasks. In this method, each task depends on the completion of the next task in the sequence. This format is different from other dependency types, such as finish-to-start, and ensures tasks are correctly aligned for working backward. Resource management ensures your team is working efficiently without overloading individuals. Assign tasks to team members in the Assign To column. Then open Project Settings, select Resource Management, and ensure it's not disabled. Select an Allocation Percent column and then OK. Open Resource Management from the toolbar and select Track Workload to access the heat map, which shows how tasks are distributed across your team. These tools ensure your project stays organized, adaptable, and on schedule. Check out the Project Settings Learning Track to learn more. Thanks for watching.